environment.
Come on, come on.
He had to deal with lions who were making ready to destroy him.
Yes, sir.
These lions were, listen, as carnivorous beings and animals. They were instinctively made to devour and to eat flesh. They're carnivorous. So, y'all, to be in this situation, there doesn't seem to be a way out.
Uh-huh.
I mean, how do you want to get out of that? You're in a lion's den, and you're with raging, roaring, and hungry lions,
yes,
who by instinct and by nature, they're designed to devour you. How do you want to get out of that?
Yeah.
But though Daniel was in a dilemma, Daniel had a devotion, and he was dedicated, and God ultimately delivered him. How do we, my brothers and my sisters, survive the lion's den of life? It's by being devoted and dedicated to God.
Yes, amen.
No matter what you're going through. Even if you're thrown into your lion's den, you remain faithful to God. Why? Because he's faithful to you.
Yes, sir.
You remain committed to God. Why? Because he's committed to you. I refer to him time and time again. I refer to him again. David was at a mature ripe age in his life. And David was able to make the statement and say, I once was young, but now I'm old. He said, but never have I seen the righteous.
Yes, sir.
Nor has he seen begging bread.
Yeah.
David said, I've gone from being young and sophomoric in my life, but I'm now a seasoned man. And he says, throughout the course of life, he says, the sum's almost this, that God was always there.
Yes.
He's always been faithful. I can't say that I've always been faithful to him. And you can't say that you've always been faithful to him. But what we can agree upon is that he's always been faithful to us.
Yes.
And my brother and my sister, we make it in our mind that I'm not going back. Thank you.